It's not only serving the purpose of, you know, protecting your officers on the street or your firefighters or anything like that, but it's giving that peace of mind to your community that that tool is out there. Right. So, I can't put into words how valuable of an asset having a drone on your agency is. I don't care if you're a 4-man agency or a 1600-man agency like I work on, for. They are invaluable. These things have saved lives. They will continue to save lives. Being able to tell a canine team or a patrol officer on the street that's looking for, you know, an armed suspect, hold behind the 3-4 corner of a house because the bad guy's on the 2-3 corner with a gun. That's immeasurable. It's priceless. You can't put a dollar amount on it. It just makes it so much safer. A couple of years ago, all we kept hearing was reimagining law enforcement, right? And I'd already started reimagining it, flying the drone. So I was like, I'm already there. So I told him in 2018, yeah, you know, I'll start our drone program. And I stepped away from canine, you know, a career I loved, but I also loved the drone stuff. And I saw the potential in it. And I knew the potential with the drones. So I did that by myself. We had a helicopter at the time, but we didn't really have a full-time pilot. So it was kind of, I was taking all the runs, if you will. I could get there much quicker than a helicopter could, because, you know, you had to get the pilot to drive down there, do a pre-flight, gas it, and then go. By that time, I'm into my second battery on a scene. So, it was a thing that you just kind of stumbled into. When I first went into it, I went into that mindset of, being a canine guy, you know, you just use it to find people, right? People that are hiding. And I did leverage a lot of the training and my experience from canine, you know, how to find people that are hiding from you, you know, path of least resistance, all that kind of stuff. And, you know, was very successful with the drone. But then I started figuring out, I was like, man, we can really use this technology. If we really want to leverage it for what we do, we can get past just looking for people. You know, we can put it in front of SWAT teams where we're putting those assets, you know, unmanned assets downrange instead of human assets, right? Peek around a corner. And the FAA, a lot of people, you talk about the FAA and they get nervous thinking, well, you know, they're in the way, they don't want us to have a program. My experience here is the FAA has bent over backwards to help me, walk me through getting our COA, who to talk to, phone numbers to call, all that kind of stuff, airspace, you know, clearance, all this kind of stuff. They're there to help you, but they want you to do it the right way. So I know when you start thinking about, oh my gosh, FAA is huge, who do I talk to and all that kind of stuff, those steps can easily be made. You just need to be shown how to do it. If you're an administrator on a public safety agency, whether it be fire, police, sheriff, EMS, or whatever, and you know this technology is out there, but wish not to invest in it, I would question it. To me, right now, it is one of the most powerful tools the public safety has. Absolutely.